Hi everyone, hope you all fine. I am also fine here. Today we will see 5 more current affairs which will be easy for you to recollect and revise. Let's go. So first one is Conference of Parties 14 of UNCCD, United Nations Convention to Combat Desertification. For the first time, India is hosting UNCCD's Conference of Parties at Greater Noida in Uttar Pradesh. And also they have released a New Delhi Declaration. Delhi Declaration is nothing but an ambitious statement which was given by our Prime Minister Modi on behalf of Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change to increase the restoration of land from 21 million hectares to 26 million hectares. Land degradation is a major problem due to climate change. It occurs due to improper utilization of water resources and crop practices. These are all the causes involved in making the fertile land into an unfertile one. So, to avoid this land degradation, our government is promoting organic farming, wetlands programs, and so many conservation programs, water conservation programs, to restore the degraded lands. So, United Nations Convention to Combat Desertification is one of the 3 Rio Conventions held in Brazil, along with United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change and Convention on Biological Diversity. So all these 3 are interrelated in the form of preserving the ecosystem. So UNCCD, there are 197 parties. India is one of the signatory party to UNCCD. I have already told signatory means when the convention is founded, we have signed in that. And party means we have ratified in our local legislation. So, Global Land Outlook released by UNCCD biennially, that is once in 2 years since 2017. So, that's all. Next. So, next, UMMID and NIDAN. This acronym type of questions will be usually asked by UPSC. Mainly, they will be asking comes under like that or it related to which topic. These and all will be asked in prelims point of view. And you can use this in GS mains paper. GS3. Okay. UMMID and NIDAN comes under Ministry of Science and Technology because it deals with a unique method to manage and treat the inherited disorders, especially from parents to the offspring. So NIDAN Kendras are supported or also supported by Department of Biotechnology under Ministry of Science and Technology. So what is the aim of UMMID means? They will be establishing NIDAN Kendras in the aspirational districts where the congenital disorders are more, to produce the skilled clinicians, that is doctors and other professionals in the human genetics, and also to screen the pregnant women and newborn babies who are all with inherited genetic disorders to find out. So the motto of UMMID is based on the National Health Policy 2017. They have shifted the focus from sick care to the wellness development. E-Sahaj portal, it is an online portal for granting clearance for the applicants who are applying online. So it comes under Ministry of Home Affairs. So we can track, the applicants can track their application from time to time, whether it is pending or approved by the government or else rejected. Okay. So what is the objective of E-Sahaj portal means? Potential security threats, including economic threats, are evaluated using this, and it promotes ease of doing business also. And risk, it provides a risk assessment before clearing the investment and project proposals in key sectors, especially in terms of industrial sectors. Okay. So what is the aim means? It provides, E-Sahaj portal provides a healthy balance and gives transparency and checks the national security. And also it promotes ease of doing business in India and promotes more investment because it is giving transparency, you know, that's all. So next, neutrinos. Neutrinos, black holes or gravitational waves will always be asked. That is the space related or the science and technology related informations will be asked in UPSC often. So now about neutrinos, they are tiny neutral elementary particles and they interact. And they interact via very weak force. They are formed by the nuclear fusion in the sun as well as in all other stars and the decay processes within their core. These neutrinos are released. They are transparent in nature and they have a seamless transfer. So what is there in erupting neutrinos? Because the origin of universe is always a questionable one. Though there are so many theories like Big Bang theory, yet we doesn't have a conclusive statement. So the key fundamental questions like origin of universe and energy production in stars can be easily determined, and the structure of the earth from the core we can easily investigate because they are transparent and they interact via the matter with a very weak force, no, and the unhindered transmission will be there. So we can easily find out the structure of the earth from core. So India based neutrino observatory is located near Theni in Tamil Nadu, and it is jointly funded by Department of Atomic Energy and Department of Science and Technology, much needed for choosing the options. Neutrinos cannot be detected easily on the surface of the earth, so their laboratory will be always in the closed mines or under a road tunnel. In India, we have constructed a neutrino laboratory in 1965. The first time the neutrinos was detected in coal or gold fields. Later, it was closed as the coal or gold field mines was also closed. So, located under a road tunnel or in closed mines. So, in Canada, it is located, Japan, Italy and USA. Neutrinos were first detected in 1930 by Wolfgang. And later, 26 years later, in 1956, Rains and Cowan detected the neutrinos near a nuclear reactor laboratory. That is when the cadmium chloride reacts with the scintillating liquid, neutrinos were detected for the first time. They were awarded Nobel Prize for Physics in 1995. So neutrinos scope will be with unhindered communication in this global era and can easily improve the digital technology to a further step, and it will be better than the now satellite communication as well as the optical fiber. So next, good governance index. It comes under, it is released by Ministry of Personnel, Public Grievances and Pensions. It is launched on the Good Governance Day, that is 25th December 2019. It is used as an uniform tool across the states to assess their administration, that is governance, and also the impact of various interventions like inculcating digital technology in all the sectors. So objective is to provide the quantifiable data. So to provide quantifiable data, that is how many people are using the digital technology to follow the administration. So which and all accessed by people, and how the portal or the governance is people friendly or citizen friendly, and the people's participation is assured. These can be used to formulate their further strategies, how to improve their governance, and outcome-oriented approaches will be there in their administration. So 10 sectors are taken into account for releasing a good governance index. See here, public health. By taking public health like Ayushman Bharat or GPS tagged Jan Aushadhi stores in their nearby locations. In agriculture and added sectors, if we take a Kisan app, and in public infrastructure and utilities are delivering messages to Aadhaar number enabled mobile numbers about the fair price items in fair price shops. In human resource development, schemes like Nai Mansal, okay, Nai Roshni schemes are Swayam, okay, so many portals are there for distance education. And in commerce and industries, just now we have seen one portal, no, Sahaj portal. So these sectors should have people in all sectors, and also in environment, economic governance, and so many applications are there, no, regarding loan or bank apps, okay. And next, judicial and public security. So like what we can say means FIR is registered now and all in online, and complaints can be registered in online itself. So social welfare and development, citizen-centric governance. So try to remember these 10 sectors because you can apply in any GS paper. From GS1 to GS4, you can apply in any paper or also in essay paper. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to App IAS channel. Till then, stay positive, stay healthy, be happy, keep smiling.